This just in, the President of the United States refused to kneel before protesters as they pass around pictures of civil rights legend Martin Luther King. The entire world has been in steep mourning ever since the great and legendary George Floyd was tragically taken from us. Pepsi, Coca-Cola, Google, Apple, Samsung, Facebook, Twitter, and even simple food manufacturers have all come forward to support a man they would have never looked twice at if they ever met him. In California, police keep a local artist protected as she expressed herself all over a building. Police were on scene to make sure no one interfered with this woman's art, suggesting that she add something for George Floyd and complimenting her on her work. Backup arrived shortly afterwards to make sure that the woman wasn't thirsty and even offered to bring her a water, a coffee, or something to eat. We all know that deep down, this would not be the case if it was George Floyd expressing his art. If this was a black man decorating the building, the cops would have been taking a knee for a completely different reason. Los Angeles is truly becoming a mark of progress. In other news, Project Veritas has promoted a new video that they hope will go viral. Let's take a look. And as you can see, they are putting in a lot of effort, in spite of the FBI officially telling us that Antifa was fake news, and people like James O'Keefe and others trust their eyes and ears and betray the work of those that put their lives on the line every day. These agents have consistently braved dangers from their desks in order to filter out the facts for us. And people like James O'Keefe refuse to take their word for it. Ungrateful and disrespectful are not strong enough of words. Also, law enforcement officials across the globe continue to follow bits of misinformation involving former model, auteur, and philanthropist Jeffrey Epstein, despite social media companies working overtime to stop fake news and falsehoods from spreading on the internet. People are still exploiting their free speech in order to slander and libel a great man who did wonders for his community. Police officers nationwide still refuse to submit to their new rulers, and despite their jobs being made more difficult, some of them still refuse to kiss the ring. Democrats came forth in subversive blackface to push for defunding the police department, but added that their salaries and pensions should not be touched for any reason at all. Laid-off police officers will be offered to work for famous people and elites for a slightly reduced rate. In related news, rappers and social media figures flock for the opportunity to morally grandstand on the grave of a man they wouldn't have hired to do their laundry. Famous Guy was quoted as saying this:
"This guy could have been my son, my cousin. This ain't acceptable. They gotta pay up. They gotta give it back, or we gonna take it back."
Shocking words, but who can blame them? These people have only been judged by the color of their skin for generations, and not even now do people respond to their actions. We tried to judge them by the content of their character, but that was unjust, unfair. One day society will be able to pay them back. And when we come back from break, a vacuum cleaner has attained voting rights in the state of California. More on that after the break.